Have you ever had to make a complex mechanism inside SOLIDWORKS and you weren't sure how it would move together? Maybe you weren't sure even how to use a mechanical mate or something like that to see how it would move. Well, we can turn on physical dynamics under the move component command. And we can see how one thing intersecting or running into another thing could move that other thing. I've got a few different examples to show you all here. Let's say we had some kind of nested slide, like maybe this is a drawer slide. You can see right now I don't have any mates that would lock it down in those slots. I can just freely drag it. Maybe I want to know how far it can drag out before it stops, but I don't know how to mate it down. If I go into the assembly tab of this assembly and choose move component, I can choose the physical dynamics option, this little button here. And now if one component hits the other one, it's gonna move it and be stuck to it. So you can see the slide stops now without having to add any additional mates. We can see it has a stroke length of about 558.9. I've got a couple more good ones. Maybe there's something like this Geneva wheel here. Oh, I got to turn move component off first. Maybe there's something like this Geneva wheel here. You can see I don't have any mates that would stop this thing or make this thing move the next thing. They're just freely spinning. I'm going to hit Control Z a couple times so I don't start in an interfering state. To make sure that you wouldn't, you could go to the Evaluate tab and hit Interference Detection. But now that I'm not, I can go into a Move Component command on the Assembly tab and turn on Physical Dynamics and click and drag. And you can see now one component is able to move the next one when it hits it. So we could see how this mechanism would work. That's pretty cool too. I've got a couple more here. Maybe it's something like this, and it's only supposed to go one way. If it starts to go the other way, it'll stop it. Well, you can see right now, it just lets things go through one another. We're not able to really check that. But if I go and hit Move Component and turn on Physical Dynamics, now when we try to move it the one way, we can see that our latch catches and stops the motion. But when we move it the other way, we can see it walks along and lets it reel that way. Check it out. It works pretty good. That's cool. All right. One more thing to show. We've got a clock mechanism. Right now, it doesn't have anything that should make it move the right way. You can even see this little bottom piece gets messed up. I'll hit Control Z. And I'll grab the Move Component command. Choose Physical Dynamics, and now if I click and drag on the right part anyways, we can see how this would move as a mechanism. We can see the time pass by. It's pretty cool. If you liked what you saw or you'd like any other tips or tricks, please visit us on the web at TriMech.com. Thanks for watching this video tech tip.